we love our job. That's what we do.
Yeah.
You know, Brian and I have been doing this, you know, for many years now. And Brian does many other things, but I just do rock and roll, really.
Oh, you do the odd thing, right?
Yeah, I do. This is my job. This is my life.
This is our job. I mean, this is kind of what made us, you know, a success in the world, you know, and we always did love it. I mean, Roger and I go back such a long way to being boys, and it's incredible. I feel so privileged that we can still do this, you know. We spent half our lives building up this legacy of songs and sort of contact with an audience, and now we can still be out there and do it. And it's wonderful that we have Adam, because without Adam, you need an extraordinary figurehead, and we do have it in Adam. So it's a gift from God. I call him the gift from God.
These guys play their butts off. I mean, it's like, it's pretty incredible. It's, you know, you're listening to riffs and fills and stuff that feel like the originals. I mean, it feels like the recordings have. I get up on stage and I'm like, it's like the record. It's amazing. It's unbelievable. It's really their skill and their talent is undeniable.
I didn't even think we'd ever get to this age. Now you don't think of it, you know.
That's right.
So kind of 35 inside.
Yeah, I'm like Roger. I'm surprised that we're still doing it now. I didn't think I would be around. You know, I'm getting close to 70 now. That's quite something to be running around on the stage with him, who's a young boy full of, you know, youthful energy and stuff. No, but I love it. I'm thrilled that we can still do this. How amazing. And it still makes people happy.
I think nobody thinks that far into the future. I mean, I don't know what I'm going to be doing next week.
Yeah, I know.
Tomorrow.
But it's great. I mean, I'm very excited to be playing all these fantastic places in Europe that we've never been to before. I think you have to do it at a certain level, and I think when we find that we can't do it at that level, I think it might be time. No, I don't know. No.
I don't know where we find the energy. We have the enthusiasm. It still turns us on. You know, we love playing, and we have the opportunity to work with a wonderful artist here, and to be Queen, you know, in some way. So it's a magical thing. I don't think either Roger or I ever thought that this would happen. We thought it was kind of done in the old days when we lost Freddie. But to find this man and be able to do Queen and do all those songs and see these happy faces, it's a miracle. It's great.
Yeah, to be able to put on a, you know, a big spectacular show. We try to play at the same intensity that we used to play, but we need a great singer, you know, to put over those songs, and this guy is a great singer. Mm.
And there's amazing music to sing, and that's a big part of it too. These songs are, they're so incredible, and they're timeless, and the audience knows every word. And these hits have been a part of their lives for ages now. And so you're getting to do music that has like a very deep connection to the audience. And they all kind of satisfy a different emotion, you know? And you know, for, you know, those moments where you want to really be cathartic and get out, you know, some deep-seated emotion, you know, like, I think Who Wants to Live Forever has this drama to it. The Show Must Go On has this drama. I think Somebody to Love is like a personal, I can relate to it very well, because...
There'd be.
You know, they're all so special.
That was Freddie's favorite, I think.
For Somebody to Love. It really says what I think everybody feels at times in their lives, but all the songs do. I can't name a favorite because the songs are so great, and they each one has like a different thing that makes it great. I mean, you go into like Radio Gaga, for example, is this amazing audience participation moment that there's nothing like it in the show except for Radio Gaga, and the audience is like so energized by the choreography that they're all doing together. And and I've been running out into the audience during that song, which is really exciting. Mm-hmm. I love them all for different reasons.
When you have tens of thousands of women, men, screaming your name, ready to do anything, how do you stay normal?
I don't know if we do stay normal.
I've never been normal.
We try.
No, we're not normal.
It's part of the secret.
Madness is very nice. We're very fortunate to have this madness. You know?
I tried them all and they didn't work.